Hey guys, I'm Philippe from Cyberbikes, and I'm here to show you how to install your Bafang Mid Drive kit and how to do it right. So let's go. So it's very important to guarantee the frame will touch the groove of the motor and not the shoulder of the motor. The motor has to be touching what we call bottom bracket of the bike. And the bottom bracket will be in contact with the groove of the motor. Never you can let the chain stay touch the shoulder of the motor because it will create damage in the internal gears of the Bafang. If your installation needs a spacer, try to use the smaller spacer you can. Why? You might be fixing one problem, but you could be creating another problem. Why you have to use the narrowest spacer in case you need a spacer is as soon as you push the motor in, you're gonna be offsetting the chain line. And we want to have the chain line as straight as possible towards the gears. We don't want to have the motor too offset away from the bottom bracket to the point that when the chain is on the first gear, we have a chain completely crossed, okay? So our advice is if you need a spacer, go with the narrowest one. The importance of the chain guide is to guide the chain to match the chain ring. If you neglect installing a chain guide, every time you shift gears, for example, to the big sprockets on the back, the chain might come off on the chain ring. So the chain guide allows you to have peace of mind when shifting gears on the bike. And shifting gears is something so important in your Bafang system. It's something that important. We are gonna make a video only about that. We know we have enough clearance between the motor shoulder and the chain stay. And now I'm gonna set this metal plate onto the frame. So I'm gonna first tie these bolts, okay? You can see my torque range. I have 10 Newton meters of torque, okay? And I heard the click, bang, that's it. I don't need more torque than this. You're gonna look at the back here. You're gonna see that we have the metal plate a little bit lifted up from the bottom bracket. Now it's where we get the nut. This nut bears about 60 Newton meters of torque. And that's exactly what we want. We want this metal plate a little bit lifted up from the bottom bracket. So when we tighten the main nut, this plate will bend in and then bite the bottom bracket. Now I have my torque wrench set to 60 Newton meters. I also have a proper Bafang tool. This is the best tool you can buy to do maintenance and work on a Bafang motor. The short little tools might work, but this is the best. So I come here and I'm start tightening. I'm bending the plate in and start to bite the frame. My stand is strong, but instead of forcing down, I'm gonna force up. I hold the frame with my other arm, I pull up. Oh, you heard the torque? That's it, bang. Your motor is firmly attached to the bike and should never come off. I have here the brake sensor, which in my opinion is my favorite. You can control when to stop the motor. You deem necessary, you can press the lever and stop the motor, or you can use the gear sensor. Every time you click the shifter, the gear shifter, the cable will move up and down and will send a signal to the controller to stop the motor while you shift gears. The main point is the gear sensor can only be connected to the controller gear sensor port. If you decide to connect the gear sensor to the brake cable in the 1-2-4 cable like this, you're gonna have a high delay when shifting gears. It's like holding the clutch for a long time when shifting the gears in your car. If you have the gear shifter, install it directly to the controller. If you decide to go with a brake cutoff, install it to the 124. And in my opinion, I would only go with this one. You should always keep those four pieces after the steering pivoting point, because this is a very strong cable, all right? So you can flex it, you can steer left and right, and this cable will always be there. However, if you keep the split behind, before the steering pivoting point, you're gonna be flexing the very narrow cables. And eventually, these cables will break apart. So to prevent any communication errors, keep the split after the steering hack. Oh yeah, guys! To finish the installation, you have to be very careful on how you pass the wires. So our technique is, you come with the controller wires and you pass it around the motor, or if you have enough gap in this triangle, of the triangle of the chainstay, you can pass the wires on the inside. But you have to be careful. Leave the wires away from any moving part, like the wheel and the chain ring, okay? If you decide to pass the wire on the inside of the triangle, use zip ties to maintain the wire away from the chain ring. Then, as the wires start to come towards the bike, what you have to look for? Look for the brake line. You can be using hydraulic brakes like we are using now, but you can be using cable brakes. You have to look for the brake lines because they are the stronger and sturdier. So you're gonna pass the electrical wires together with the brake line, so you can make something clear, nice and tidy at the same time that the electrical wire is being supported but by a very strong wire, which is the brake system. One thing that you should never do is getting the controller wires and passing them in between the frame and the motor. Do never do that, because the motor might come loose after a crash or after too much pedaling. Sometimes people have strong legs, yeah? So if the motor comes loose and you have passed the wires between the frame and the motor, you know what's gonna happen? The motor will bite the wires and will create a short circuit. You may lose the motor, you know, you may damage the complete system. So never pass the wires between the frame and the motor. Also, never pass the wires, as I've seen a few times, underneath the motor like this and then over here. Why? This motor gets very hot and the heat produced by the motor might melt the wires. And if you go off-roading or you're gonna pass over a set of stairs, sometimes the motor can be hit by a stone, by a brick, by a step. So don't pass the wires in front of the motor because you might tear the wires off. And people sometimes crash, they fall. So you have to allow the wires to steer at least 180 degrees, at least 180 degrees. Like in this case, the wires are still loose and I can rotate it for 180 degrees. Thank you very much for watching our videos. Don't forget to subscribe, check the bell for notifications, give us a like, and write your comments. We are gonna be constantly posting videos on Instagram, Facebook, and YouTube, and your opinion really matters to us. So stay tuned for more.